Good morning, dear students. I hope you have seen the last video of this chapter. And let's we continue with the topic. And before starting, let's we revise whatever we have learned in our last video. That we have learned about the crops and management and about the crops production. Clear? So I am writing here the basic points which we have learned in our last video. Right now, don't write in your notebook, okay? Because I am revising the last things. First, we have learned about the crop. The simple meaning of crop means any crop or any food that we can produce on a large scale. That is called a crop. Now, crop considered as a vegetables, fruits, and cereals crops. Wheat, rice, jowar, bajra, that all are called as a crop. Clear? Now, we have learned about the management. The meaning of management is to manage the crops after production on a large scale. That is called a management. Clear? Now, after that, we have studied about the two types of crops. That is, one is rabi crop and another one is kharif crop. Now, rabi crop, it means the winter season. The crops that grows under the season of winter, and the kharif crop growing under the season of rain. Clear? Now this crops require more amount of water, and these crops are called as that are growing from the October to March, and that crops are growing from the September, June to September. Clear? Which are going from the October to March, and these are the June to September. So this we have studied about the types of crops, and after that we have listed and we have discussed about the basic practices of crop production.
Let's start with the first step.
step, that is the preparation of soil. The first. Now from this onward, you have to write it down in your notebook, because with this you have already written. Okay. So now let's fix that with the first step, that is preparation of soil. Clear? Now it will be asked in an exam like that. Explain this in a brief. Explain in brief how you will prepare the soil for the crop production. Okay, and the question might be asked like this: that if any land is not good for the crop building, if you want to grow any crop on that land, what you will do? Okay, for that you have to do some kind of treatment. Okay, as I have told you, preparation of soil means giving some kind of treatment to the soil and make the soil fertile and suitable for the good crop yielding. Okay, so this is the first step, and we can say the most important step for the crop production, as well as and this is the very important step in the agriculture. Important in agriculture for the turning the soil and loosening the soil. The preparation of soil means turning soil and loosening the soil. Turning the soil, it means the soil, we have to give some kind of treatment to the soil, and the loosen. As we know, the soil is porous in nature. The soil is porous in nature. Now here the meaning of porous, it means there are some pores into the soil. As we know, the soil is the solid matter. As you have studied about the three states of matter: solid, liquid, and gas. And the soil is the one of the solid matter. It's called the porous. The soil particles are closely packed to the each other. And when we are giving some kind of treatment to the soil, and that particles have become loose. Okay, so this particle has become loose, and that is called porous. Okay, for example, you have seen the sponge. Okay, when you dip the sponge into the water, they soak the water. So the soil is act like a sponge. Porous means वहाँ पे उस चीज में छोटे-छोटे pores होते हैं. Okay, when you pour the water into the soil, the water is directly absorbed by the soil particles. Here you can see the space and in which the oil, in which the all water, nutrients, minerals are soaked by the roots. And in that place only the roots are growing. Okay, so now you understood the loosening and turning the soil, because soil is the porous in nature. Once the soil becomes loose, it helps to penetrate the root deep into the soil. Okay, once the soil becomes loose, it helps to penetrate roots deep into the soil. Now here the meaning of penetrate means to grow. Okay, when, because the roots is the only support of the plant that connects the soil, and that gives the stamina to the plant to grow. Okay, so it helps to penetrate the roots deep growth. And this is the one function that why soil become loose. So soil को loose करने के पीछे कारण क्या है? What is the reason? Because it helps to penetrate the roots for the good crop production. And after that, the soil. Do you think the soil is the only component that helps to grow the plant? No, because the soil consists of many other organisms. Okay, apart from the organisms, it has some minerals and nutrients which helps to grow the plant. The soil has the nutrients, minerals.
Much better than that material.
such as plants and animals, mix with the soil. So when soil के साथ mix हो जाता है तो उसका decompose हो जाता है, right? फिर decompose होने के बाद वो soil में mix होता है and nutrients and minerals बनाता है. And that nutrients and minerals used by the plants. And after that plants when plants died, animals died, and then again the soil decomposed and उसमें से हमें nutrients और minerals मिलते हैं. अब वो plant use करते हैं. Okay, this way in the soil the nutrients and minerals will come. Okay, so this is about the just introduction. Right, if you want to note down the major points, you can note down either. If you have, and you must have the textbook, right? I don't say that if you have, you must have the textbook, okay? And in that textbook, you have to find it out this main points and underline it. And based upon that main points, you have to write it down in your notebook, in your language. Clear? Till now, let's be move forward. Now, next is the only a few centimeter of the soil layer and consists of many more nutrients compared to the other layers of the soil. We can say the top layer of the soil has more amount of nutrients, and that nutrients is used by the plants easily. Okay, and that nutrients is helps for the cultivation of the crop production. Okay, now here the one definition is the process of tilling and loosening. So the process of loosening and turning the soil is called tilling and plowing. Okay, हम जो process कर रहे हैं, prepare कर रहे हैं soil को, जो preparation है soil की, that process is known as tilling and plowing. And this is done by the plough, as you have know also, because most of the students have visited the farm, and this is the name of instrument implementation for the farm. Okay, and that plough, and the plough is made up of wood or either iron. Okay, when soil is very dry. Because it is not necessary that all the time the soil is become very moist. No, when the soil becomes very dry, it need to water in the soil. What happens when we water the soil soil become loose. Okay, and it is very needed when watering when the soil is very dry, the watering before the plucking. And the field may have a big clumps, means if mitti ke bade bade stones ban jate hain sometimes, so it need to broken down into the smaller pieces, either in the fine particles, tiny particles. And the field this is done by the some kind of instrument like a plow, hoe, either cultivator. Okay, and that big clumps is called as a crown. Before the after preparation of soil, it need to level the soil into the equal part, that it is beneficial for the sowing the seed. Okay, and for the irrigation also, because irrigation it means to supply the water into the different field of the crop, and it's done by the level. Manure is added before the tilling. Why here the manure is added? Why we prepare the soil? Because it helps the soil to become more nutrient, to become more fertile. So these are the preparation of the soil. We have looked at the we have studied that why it needs to prepare the soil before the crop production. And now we'll see what are the agriculture implements are to be used for for the preparation of the soil. There are three main implements which are going to which are used. The first is club, second one is hoe, and third one is cultivator. These three implements are used basically in agriculture practices. Now the first in this three implements given in your textbook also as a part of picture, you can see it, and the textbook keep it with you so that it will be easy for you to understand. The plough picture is given in your textbook. It is used in ancient time for the loosing and adding the fertilizer into this to the crop, and the plough structure is given. There is a plough shaft and plough spear is also given, and it is a one big iron rod which is fixed with the one pair of bull, either any other animal, either the camel, either cow, buffalo, whatever. The one pair of animal fixed with the plough. Clear? Now second one is the hoe. Hoe is also a long rod of wood or iron. It is a strong and broad and bent blade. Means this implements having the blade. That blade is helps to breaking down the clumps into the simpler parts. And this is managed by the animal. Means it pulled by the animal. Now last one is the cultivator. The cultivator you all have seen, because nowadays these only implements are used in our agriculture practices, because it is pulled by the controlled by the tractor driven, and use of cultivator saves the labor and time, because there is no labor work and learning. Stay safe, stay healthy. Thank you all.